Hey yo, what's happening? I hope you guys are enjoying the last few days of summer. If school has already started for you, good luck. I hope you guys are crushing it right now. But today we're going to be talking about what laptop is right for you. When it comes to college, having a laptop is just about one of the most important essential things a student can have in their backpack, because you're going to be using it for taking notes, surfing the web, answering emails. Just about everything you need in college is going to be done on your laptop. But when it comes to finding out which one you need to purchase, there are literally hundreds, if not thousands, of options to choose from. So today I'm just going to kind of break it down into what I think is the most efficient and the best bang for your buck. If you guys are enjoying these videos and want to hang out with me on the gram, my Instagram handle is at Nicholas Che. Give me a follow and let's roll that intro sequence. Now, before you go to Best Buy and pick out a laptop and realize that, oh crap, this might not be the best one that I need, I think it's very important to analyze what you're going to be using your laptop for. So personally, like you guys know, I'm a photo and video editor. So the one that I use personally is the MacBook Pro 2016 15-inch with the touch bar. I'll throw it up right here, but I'm using the 15-inch MacBook Pro 2016 model, 2.6 gigahertz Intel Core i7 with the touch bar and 16 gigs of RAM. Now, for me, this laptop has done a pretty good job of handling my photo and video editing when I'm using Photoshop, Premiere, Lightroom, After Effects. It does most of it okay. Sometimes I do wish I had a little bit faster laptop, or maybe even an iMac or Mac Pro. So that might be something I might look into in the future. But for this laptop, which I use for portability's sake and just having it with me at all times, it does the job fine and it's a complete workhorse. However, it does come at a hefty price tag. I think when I bought it, I did buy it refurbished for around $1,800. I spec'd out the RAM just a little bit, but that is a hefty price tag to be paying for something as simple as a laptop when there are much more affordable options out there, especially with the new MacBook Pro that just came out. Personally, I don't think that I need it right now, especially since I just bought one. But if you are looking to get into more photo and video editing or gaming or something that needs a lot of computer intensive graphics or memory, then you might look into those newer options as well. Now, what I personally recommend for most people going into college who aren't doing anything photo or video intensive, or if you don't know what I'm talking about when it comes to processor or RAM or gigabytes or blah, 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 then this laptop is probably the one that's right for you, and that is the MacBook Air or the MacBook itself. These are Apple's kind of mid-tier, lower-end models, which aren't as pricey, but still offer a lot of the capabilities that a normal MacBook Pro does. If you do have an iPhone, I think one of the most enticing features of having a MacBook ecosystem is it's so well integrated. Things like iPhoto, AirDrop, iMessage, which is super important for me so I can message during class, Air, iCloud. Those are just a few of the key things that I love about having an iPhone and MacBook ecosystem, because it just goes well so effortlessly. The color schemes match super well, and I know that in the future, since Apple is going to be releasing more updates, it's just going to be even better integrated. So if you do have an iPhone, I highly recommend getting some kind of MacBook. Now, the difference between the MacBook and the MacBook Air is very minute. I'm looking at the website right now, and basically the MacBook Air is just a slightly slimmer. It doesn't have as much RAM, it doesn't do as much powerful computing as the MacBook. But if you're someone who just needs to do emails, take basic notes, surf the web, watch YouTube videos, then the MacBook Air could be the right fit for you. And then if you need just a little bit more capabilities, then look into the MacBook as well. Right now, the MacBook Air 13-inch is going for $1,000. The MacBook is going for $1,300. I personally, right now, if I was getting a new computer, I would kind of look into the MacBook just because it's the more newer version. It has a lot cooler colors. It has USB-C and super cool feature. Heads up, if you are purchasing, I think it's a new MacBook or a new iPad Pro, Apple is giving out free Beats headphones, so highly recommend that. I love Beats headphones, I think they're really great, so definitely check out that promo code down below. Not sponsored, I wish Apple would sponsor this, but anyway, moving on. If you aren't interested in the Apple ecosystem, there are plenty of other options out there, much more affordable, I will say, possibly the same specs, even faster, whatever the case may be. The few that come to the top of my head are the Surface Book, the Dell XPS, and the HP Spectre. Now, personally, I have never used any of these computers, so I'm not talking from I've used this computer before, I recommend it, blah, blah, blah. It's just from what I've seen and from what other people on my campus are using, I think these are the other great options for college laptops. The Surface Book, I think, works really great because it doubles as a laptop and a tablet, meaning that you can pull out the dock, use a stylus, and if you are doing something like pre-med or engineering where you're going to be drawing a lot of graphs, doing calculations, and you need that stylus, then the Surface Book could be the right fit for you. I think that Microsoft is doing a really great job in innovation, and just their technology right now is really on a different level, and it's super fast, super portable. The price is roughly around the same as just kind of a mid-tier MacBook or maybe even a MacBook Pro if you're getting the Surface Pro or the Surface Book. Personally, I don't know too much of the details, but I do know that it is a great computer. It actually looks really sexy. I do enjoy that you can flip out the keyboard and use a stylus. I think that's something that I wish the MacBook Pros had. Now, the other options, like I said, are the Dell XPS and the HP Spectre. I haven't heard too much about the XPS, the Dell one, but I know that it does really great 4K video, Premiere, photo video editing. Like, it's on par with the MacBook Pros, even faster, because Premiere does kind of tend to work better with the Microsoft ecosystem compared to Final Cut working better with the Apple, which makes sense. But these are a little bit more affordable option. They're cheaper than the Surface Book. The Dell XPS is going for, depending on if you get the 13 inch or the 15 inch, they range from $800 to $1,000, and the HP Spectre, if I'm guessing correctly, it's roughly around the same price tag as well. The cool thing about the HP Spectre, one of my best friends has it, and there's the HP Spectre 360, which does a full 360 turnaround, and that is also touchscreen, and you can use a stylus, I'm pretty sure, and that may be the best fit for you. Other things to take into consideration are your specific majors, like computing and engineering and computer science. I know that they have specific programs that require different computers that will work with them better. So look into what your specific school requires and purchase a computer based on that. Another pro tip is a lot of schools actually offer services where they will subsidize or make a cheaper laptop option to purchase from their actual website. I know that Princeton offered like a $200 discount if you bought it from them. I don't understand why, but it does include a lot of cool software and some kind of Apple Care and just kind of like an insurance and warranty program. So if your school does offer that, that may be something to consider as well. And the final option is the iPad Pro. Now, personally, I have both a MacBook Pro and an iPad Pro. I tend to use my iPad Pro when it comes to notes, just because I like using my pencil to do handwritten notes. And then I have it synced up with my MacBook Pro so I can access those notes later on my laptop when I need to study. Obviously, this may not be feasible to have both, but if you are the type of person who is pretty tech savvy and can live without having a laptop, then, you know, by all means, go for just having an iPad. I think that it's super sleek, super portable, and by far the most affordable option. You can access your emails, social media, still do Instagram, still take notes, still do whatever a normal laptop would do, but may not have as much flexibility or as much capability as you would need. That about wraps it up for this video. I hope you guys are enjoying these back to school videos, just because I know that there's a ton of questions that you guys have been having, and I'm hoping that I can answer them as fast as possible before I have to go back to school. If you like this video, make sure you give it a like down below, comment any more things you guys want to see, and I'll see you guys next time. I'm sorry, 50 dub, I even got it tatted on me. 81, they'll bring the crashers to the party. And you know me, turn the 02 into the 03, dog. Without 40 Ollie, there be no me. Imagine.